Welcome to the discussion of key suppressing operators in RxJava's observable class. These operators create an observable and or a single that can change or ignore portions of its payload. We'll be talking here about the filter, take, and ignore elements suppressing operators. Let's start by talking about the filter operator. This operator evaluates each source value against the given predicate. This predicate is passed as a parameter. If the predicate test succeeds, filter will emit the value. In contrast, if the predicate test fails, the value will be ignored and filter will make a request upstream for the next item. Filter returns a new observable that only contains values that pass the predicate test. As a result, the number of output elements may actually be less than the number of input elements. Of course, if all the predicate tests pass, then the number of output elements will be the same as the number of input elements. But if for some reason some of the tests fail, then you get less output elements than you did as input elements. The example shown here is from a case study we'll look at the end of the lesson. And what it does is it generates a bunch of random big integers, and then it will only emit odd numbers because there's no point in checking to see if even numbers are going to be prime since they couldn't possibly be prime. Note also that filter can't change the type or the value of the elements that it processes. Project Reactor has a filter operator in its flux class that behaves the same way as the filter operator does in the observable class for RxJava. And this example is pretty much identical, except it's using a flux rather than an observable. Both these operators are very similar to the stream filter method in the Java Streams class. And this particular example shown here will only emit odd numbers. It's just a different way of doing that using Java Streams. Let's now turn our attention to the take operator. This suppressing operator will take only the first n values from the observable if they're available. The parameter n indicates the number of items that we want to have emitted from this observable. It returns an observable that's limited to the number n, or less if there are not that many items, of course, at all. You can use take to limit otherwise infinite streams. For example, we talked earlier about the interval factor method operator, which can be used to generate an infinite sequence of integers periodically in a background thread. Since we don't want to have this program run endlessly, we can use the take suppressing operator to stop emitting after S max iteration values are emitted. And we'll take a look at this when we take a look at the case study at the end of this lesson. Project Reactor also has a take operator defined in its flux class that works the same way. Both of these methods are very similar to the limit method that's defined in Java Streams stream interface. So here's an example where we're going and collecting a bunch of items that are going to be odd numbers and then being able to store them after limiting the number of to the first 100. Finally, we're going to talk about the ignore elements suppressing operator. This operator can be used to ignore all items emitted by the current observable. It only calls on complete or on error. It never calls on next. And it returns a new completable instance, where completable basically is just something that indicates it's completed. This data suppressing operator essentially ignores its payload altogether, unlike filter, which conditionally ignores certain items that it emits, or take, which limits the number that are going to be emitted. So we often use this at the end of our observable chains in order to indicate that an asynchronous operation has completed. And you'll see how this is used in the case study at the end of the lesson, where we're going to emit a bunch of big integers that we're going to check to see if they're prime, when we're going to have do on complete to basically print debugging information when we're done. And finally, we use ignore elements to return a completable that's an indicator to the async task barrier that we're done with our test. Project Reactor doesn't really have an exact equivalent to ignore elements. However, its then operator can be used in a very similar way. And it's often used, as we do with the Project Reactor version of async task barrier, to indicate that some sequence of operations that are chained together on a flux have completed either synchronously or asynchronously. So that's the end of our discussion of key suppressing operators in the RxJava observable class.